sourdough differs from normal bread, as you might call it, by the fact that we're using a wild starter instead of baker's yeast. So baker's yeast is one single strain of wild yeast which is mass produced to create this milky substance of yeast that's then compressed into a block, and that's trillions of cells, which means you can make bread much, much quicker without any time of developing that dough and growing that yeast. It's already been grown. With a sourdough, you don't know what type of yeast you're going to get in your bread, so you get lots of different yeast creating different flavours. What you do with the wild yeast is you grow it from a small culture. Wild yeast settles on the outside of a grain berry. As soon as that's ground into flour and you add water to it, it begins to feed on the sugars. When it feeds on the sugars, it creates alcohol and it creates gas, the gas being CO2. 5 days' time, you'll start to see some bubbles popping up into the culture. Those bubbles are the first sign that the yeast is beginning to take a hold and grow. Lactobacillus is basically a good bacteria that grows alongside the yeast. That's what gives sourdough its name. It creates lactic acid. It gets sharper and sharper, gives it its flavour. So it's a very important thing that the two grow together. In the morning, when you come into the bakery, it smells more like a brewery because of all the starters fermenting, creating alcohol and gas. We then take a little bit of that, feed it with fresh flour and water, and by the next day, it's bubbling away like mad, and that is your culture. And once you've created that culture, you just have to keep feeding it every day. Keep a little bit back and feed it, and that will last you forever, as long as you remember to feed it every day. 30% of the dough is made up of the culture. Unlike a small amount of yeast you would add to bread, we're adding 30% of this culture to fresh flour and water to make the dough. The dough is then mixed to allow the proteins to join together. The proteins are what trap the gas. So you've got two different types of protein that create this chewy gum-like texture to the dough that trap the gas produced by the yeast. We allow it to proof to double its size. This takes quite a long time when making a sourdough because you're growing yeast. So once the dough's developed or proofed, we've got this massive marshmallow of dough. So we're then gently shaping it because we don't want to lose all those pockets of gas. It's taken a long time for that wild yeast to create the gas. We don't want to knock it out, so we gently shape it, round it up. We then put that shaped dough floured into baskets. That helps to create the crust around the outside of the bread, holding it together, and it allows it to rise within the basket so we keep the shape. The proteins are trapping the gas and create those big holes, synonymous with sourdough. We then turn it out onto wooden peels, score it, and then load it straight onto the stone in the oven. Sourdough has something in it that normal bread doesn't have, and that's a lot of time in its production, which makes it more digestible. It gives it more flavour, more texture. You can squash it flat, it will bounce back. It gives it a better crust as well. Flavour is the biggest thing, though. It completely changes the flavour of the bread.